equivalent static method. You can see VB. What do you mean by VB is called design base shear. If you are having any structure, base dimension, which is D, and overall height of the structure, which is called H. First, you have to find the base shear. What is the formula of VB? B is termed to be as base, B is termed to be as shear. Base shear equals AH into W. H is called horizontal, A is called acceleration, horizontal acceleration. Design horizontal acceleration coefficient value as per 6.4.2. W is called seismic weight of the building. If any building is existing, it does has a self weight. So this is called the self weight. W is called the self weight. Equivalent static method can be used for a height of 15 meter. If your problem, they have given in exam, if the height of the building has more than 15 meter, you should not use this. In seismic zone 2 only. If your zone becomes 3, 4 or 5, if these three zones are there, then you cannot use this method. In module 4, you have two types of analysis. Determination of seismic lateral force by two method. First method is equivalent static method. Second one is response spectrum method. If your problem has less than 15 meter height and if your building is located in zone 2, example Bangalore, Mysore, these are the areas are in zone 2, then you can use this equivalent static method. And what is the formula for that? VB. What do you mean by VB? If earthquake force is existing and if it is exerted at the base of the building, each and every floor carries the shear force. If any object is moving, unless otherwise a force is given, the building will not move. What is happening during an earthquake? The building is moving to and fro. Think scientifically, if anything is pushing, unless or otherwise, no object moves. So some force is pushing. What is that force? Here in code book they have given as shear force. So due to shear force, the object gets movement. Okay, how to find? You have the formula. VB is termed to be what? B is base, B is shear. So VB can be found out by AH into W. You have to find weight of the building. Now, in class 7.6.2, for RC MRF, what do you mean by MRF? Moment resisting frame building. For ordinary moment resisting frame building, next one is called RC. Steel bridges are being built by their girders will be purely in steel, and above that the slab will be RC, reinforced cement. If those kind of structure are there, you have to use TA, time period. In dynamic analysis, T is called as capital T, not small t. Small t is time. Capital T is what? Time period. So time period can be found out by 0.08 h power 0.75. If you are constructing only by using steel, you have to use 0.085 h power 0.75. H is height of the building. So how will you find height of the building? According to the picture given. Do you have this picture in code book? Find this picture. If your building is having a rectangular plan, either in top or in the elevation, if you have this kind of profile for a building, you have to use height as this. Section B, buildings with RC structural walls. If you are constructing structural walls, that is RC in the sense shear wall, you have to use this formula. 0.075 h power 0.75 divided by root of AW. What is AW? They have given this formula. Okay. Now this C case is all other buildings. You have to use this formula. The first step, you are going to find natural period of vibration, that is TA. Without infills, you can use 0.075, that is available in 7.6.2. If you are having infills, you can use this formula. Determination of other important factors. What are they? AH, horizontal acceleration. Z is zone factor, I is importance factor, SA by G is acceleration coefficient, R is called response reduction factor. These factors are available, you can copy from the guideline. Next, step 4 is determination of vertical seismic coefficient. P wave, S wave, Love wave, Rayleigh wave. The P wave will just move the object front and back. S wave will move the object up and down. Then Love wave will move the object in horizontal wave. Then finally Rayleigh wave will move the structure into rotational mode. So these four types of movement is going to happen in the structure. If you want to find vertical acceleration, the building is going to accelerate in horizontal mode as well as in the vertical mode. So if you want to find horizontal acceleration, you can use AH. If you want to find vertical acceleration, 2/3 of design horizontal seismic coefficient. If you have this answer, AH, you can multiply by 2/3 to find the vertical seismic coefficient. Then determination of design base shear, VB equals AH into W, distribution of equivalent lateral load. The design base shear computed shall be distributed along height of the building as per the formula. Seismic weight of floor in I. If you have 7 floors, then 7 floor weight has to be distributed into HI. What is HI? Height of floor in I. If you are taking first floor, substitute the first floor weight and first floor height. That is, imagine if you are having 7 floors like this. If you want to find the 7th floor seismic force, what is the height you have to substitute? One floor is, take it as 3 meter height, then 7th floor height will be 21. So you have to substitute. If you want to find Q for 7th floor, Q is known as what? Design lateral force. Design lateral force for 7th floor, you have to substitute height of 7th floor, that is 21. If you want force at 1st floor, then substitute height as what? 3 meter. So like that, whatever floor you need the seismic force, substitute the respective floor and the respective weight of that floor. A 3-storied symmetrical RC school building situated at Bhuj with the following data. Here a note is given as special moment resting frame. How they are constructing the building, special moment resting frame, and the dimensions are given below. The plan dimension is 7 meter, story height is 3.5 meter. Then to calculate all the beam weight, total weight of beams in the story is 130 kN. That is 13 tons. Only the beam having 13 tons of load. Total weight of the slab in story is 250 kN. Understand that self weight of beam will be more or self weight of slab will be more? Slab will be more. Note that in whatever structure you are constructing, the beam self weight will be less and slab self weight will be more than that. And total weight of the column is 50 kN. If you compare beam and column, the column has less self weight. If you count the number of beams and columns in any building, number of beams will be more, number of column will be less. Total weight of walls in story, 530 kN. Now, more than the slab, you have walls. You will be having multiple number of walls in a slab. One will be partition for halls, one will be partition for a kitchen. So you have number of partition walls. Weight of terrace floor is 655 kN. The structure is resting on hard rock. They have given the foundation status. Determine the total base shear and lateral load at each floor level for 5% damping using seismic coefficient method. The other word for equivalent static method is seismic coefficient method. Why they call like this? You have a coefficient VB equal to AH. What is AH? Horizontal seismic coefficient. So that is why in other words they call it as seismic coefficient method. 6.4 is design acceleration spectrum, where you can find this formula. Step 1, TA, determination of natural period. What kind of structure they have given? either you have steel, RC, infill frames or bare frames. RC building, okay. Now, do you have infilling walls in this structure? You have wall loads. So, what are the three cases? 7.6.2, bare moment resting frame. What do you mean by bare moment resting frame? Without any masonry infills. Do you have masonry infills here? Yes, you should not use case A. You have to use for all other buildings. What is case B? Buildings with RC structural wall. What do you mean by RC structural wall? Shear wall. Have they indicated any shear wall is constructed? No. So you have to use KC. What is KC? TA equal to 0.09H root of D. So if you are writing this, what is H? Height of building. What is height of building? Story height is 3.5. What is the base dimension? D. 7 meter. How many stories are there? 3 stories. Then 3 into 3.5. 10.5. When substituting the height, what they have given? Height as total height, not the individual story height. 0.357 seconds. Determination of other important factors. What are the important factors? So here you write AH. What is AH? AH equal to horizontal acceleration, seismic coefficient, Z by 2, SA by G divided by RI. This is your formula. Z by 2, SA by G, R by I. Here you have to find SA by G for rocky strata or hard soil sites. What is the T value you got? 0.325. You have rock soil or stiff, medium soil or soft soil within these three. You have hard rock soil. That is what they have given in problem. It is resting on hard rock. So you have to look into this case. For hard rock, what is your time period from 0 to 0.4? This is the first case. So your value lies between this. If your value is more than 0.4 to 4 second, you can use second one. So for this case, you will be having first one. And SA by G value is 2.5. Now you have Z, annex E. You take down last page. You have annex E, list of some towns with population more than 3 lakhs. Bhuj is the construction site. Now do you find Bhuj here? Zone 5. Table number 8, you have importance factor. Critical governance building, schools, signature building, monument building, example. They have given lots and lots of example. So in which category it comes? Category 2 is residential or commercial building, and category 3 is all other building. In case 1, can you find school building? School, then you have to take I as what? 1.5. Table 9, special moment resting frame. So check the R. RC building with special moment resting frame, R value is what? 5. Now find AH. You know all the components. Step 3, determination of horizontal seismic coefficient. Now in step 2, you have found all the coefficients. In step 3, determination of horizontal seismic coefficient, AH equal to by 2 I by R SA by G. You will be getting answer of 0.135. What are the things to be found out? VB equal to what? AH into W. Have you found AH? Yes. AH we have found. Next you have to find W. What is W? Weight of each floor. Now, determination of seismic weight. Weight of one story equals total weight of beams, slabs, column plus wall plus the live load. These are all dead load, isn't it? Beam, slab, columns or walls are dead load. Plus the live load is the weight of one story. Now, what they have given? Total weight of beam is 130, slab is 250, column is 50, walls are 530 and live load they have given as 130 kN. So you have to add all for a single floor weight. You will be getting 1090. The first floor will be having 1090. Second floor is also 1090. Weight of the terrace will be without live load. Do you have live load at roof? No live loads will be there. Hence, weight of terrace floor is given as 655. Total weight of building W equals 3-story. First 2-story will be having live load. Roof will not having live load. So the total load is 1090 into 2 plus 655. What is the total weight of building? 2835 kN. Determine the base shear. BB equal to AH into W. You will be getting 382.725 kN. Distribution of equivalent lateral load. The design base shear can be found out for each floor by using this formula. Weight 1090, height is 3.5. H1 is first floor height.